Cincinnati, the first team from outside the Power Five and the so-called Group of Five to make it into the playoff. And they came off a season in which they played Georgia right down to the wire. Lost in a last-second field goal in the Peach Bowl. And I know last year's not supposed to matter, but it gave the Bearcats some real equity. Then they went to Notre Dame and did what nobody else has been able to do lately. They won in South Bend and convincingly, 24-13. And in the American Conference Championship game, Houston was on an 11-game winning streak, and the Bearcats pulled away and finished a perfect 13-0 regular season, the only undefeated team in college football, and Cincinnati's on its way to the playoff. Bearcats will take on Alabama in Arlington. Luke Fickell is joining us now. So, Luke, all of this time, you've been able to keep a narrow focus, make sure that your team got better. Now that you're in the playoff, what's the significance of this milestone, this landmark, for teams from outside the Power Five, your team being the one to make the playoff?
Well, I don't think that, all year we've kind of tried to avoid saying that we're carrying the flag or we're doing something outside of, taking care of ourselves and representing, what it is that we do in our program, our community, our university, and our city. And I think sometimes when you start saying you're carrying a flag or doing something for somebody else or trying to make a statement for, a bunch of different programs, I think you can get lost in a lot of the things that are going on. So try to stay focused on us and what this is about.
And what it's about next is taking on Alabama, and you guys will have an opportunity to win the game. You've got guys on the outside that can match up with their wide receivers. Well, what's your impression of the matchup in the early going, the initial impression of a matchup with Alabama?
Well, I can't say that I've studied much of anything that they've done, obviously just watching, from afar this year at times. They're a great football team. They've got great talent across the board. Everybody talks about their offense, but the coach over there does a pretty good job on defense as well. So, we know it's going to be an incredible challenge for us, and I think that's what gives us the best opportunity is our guys have done nothing but step up to challenges. And I think, we'll be kind of excited about maybe putting the shoe on the other foot than they've had a lot of this year.
Coach, congratulations. I think I might be as relieved as anybody that I feel like we finally got this done. But, Coach, honestly, anytime there is a job opening anywhere, your name is first to come up. How have you been able to stay focused on the job, but not just you staying focused, but keeping your team locked in on the job ahead of them, as opposed to all of the talk out there every single time a job opens up?
Well, I think it's a little bit easier for me because I try not to turn on anything and just try to stay, kind of head down and not overly worry about it. This year, I think, was a little bit different just, by the nature of where our team was and some of the talk going into the season. If it wasn't for, having 30-some seniors and, the Desmond Ritters and the Joel DeBlancos and the Kobe Bryants and those kind of guys that really could handle whatever was being said out there, whether it was about, not playing well enough or style points or you've got to win like this or, coach is this or your coach has this. I mean, if it wasn't for those guys and their ability to control the locker room, I think it would have been a lot more difficult for our entire team and our entire program. But those guys, I tell you, did a phenomenal job of handling everything that's been thrown at them. And I mean not on the football field, but most importantly off the football field.
Coach, I remember we were sitting at this table last year, and of course you guys ran and went undefeated. You didn't get in the playoff. And I remember being so impressed when we were talking to you, because we get a lot of coaches that come on here and they bang their fist against the table and they're still trying to make their case after it's too late. Yet you seemed almost very grateful for the opportunity. You remained positive. You knew you were going to go back to work. And you had this belief that this year your team was going to get another crack at it. What was it that you saw and made you believe that you would have another chance come this time around?
Obviously when you've got the group of seniors you got coming back and, everybody wants to talk about, you got the schedule that can set you up for it. And, those things are completely out of your control. Those things are done so far in advance. But, just knowing that, what you had coming back, I think obviously it starts with the quarterback and with Desmond. But even knowing what we had defensively and our ability to play in all phases of the game, we were going to be in the mix. Now, whether we would take care of our business, whether we'd be able to handle all the, obstacles and struggles that were going to come throughout everybody's season, you never know that. But, you felt like, hey, we're in a good place. We're continuing to grow. Things are meant to be, and you got to take care of your own business, and it'll happen.
Luke, we keep going back to last year. But last year when this came out, you played Georgia and played them well. And you had, like you keep talking about, most of that nucleus coming back to this year. What did you learn about your team that maybe you didn't even know back in August, that you learned about them, that you now have them, you know, better understanding of where they've grown since you guys broke camp back in August?
Well, I think the biggest thing, you know, we after that last year, obviously we got, you know, some more notoriety and a lot of individual, you know, kind of publicity. We had some really, really high-end players coming back with bright futures to play at the next level. And I think going into the season, you were kind of, hey, how are we going to handle all of this with the attention, the individual awards and the stats and all that kind of stuff? And how will we handle that as a team? Because that's one thing we've never had to worry about. You know, I mean, maybe all league players, but other than that, our ability to kind of stay together and not overly worry about, hey, how many catches am I getting, or how many sacks am I getting, or how many tackles am I getting, and really kind of stay in that true philosophy of, hey, that's about the team and we've got to do all this stuff together. I think that's what I learned from these guys this year, that they have the ability to do that because of their maturity and their belief in one another.
Luke, I don't know who's done a better coaching job, you or Amy, with your clothing and your outfit, big fella. I mean, you got monogram on the cuff. You got some red buttons on the jacket.
I don't know.
That is impressive for you.
No, where's the pocket square?
I mean, hey, as a former three technique, you got to teach Pollock some of these tricks.
Pollock's got a pocket square.
Come on now.
Luke, you got to step up.
Don't give me all that crap. I was a nose guard, guys, not a three tech.
Oh, yeah.
I figured Joey, of all guys, the guy that would, you know, we'd have to harass because we'd be running laps and he'd be sitting in the middle kind of laughing at us, drinking water because they were taking care of him so much when he was in college.
Exactly.
He would recognize
exactly.
The clothing.
Things,
you know.
Thank
Some
you.
Of us guys, you know, us grunts, we just go about working.
That's right.
Nothing's changed, Joey, in case you're wondering.
That is so impressive, Luke. You look good, man.
Well, Luke, I just hope that you can get Joey's ring size since earlier he said, we got into the playoff here. We got this done. He's looking forward to you sending.
He's been wanting
some
to be
slack.
Our defensive coordinator for several years.
Thanks for watching ESPN on YouTube. For live streaming sports and premium content, subscribe to ESPN+.